Tell me about Mount Shasta, because I hear a lot of things about that place. Are there extraterrestrials that are said to roam there? What's the deal?
I mean, what there is like whatever you could possibly want. So, right. So like I'd read these stories about how like park rangers in like the 30s at Mount Shasta were complaining that there were a bunch of like kind of weird cultists. And I thought, well, that's strange. I wonder if that's still happening. So I go to Mount Shasta, right? I grew up in California, so I remember seeing it from the freeway, but I'd never actually gone there. And that town, you know, first of all, it's this really beautiful little mountain town. It's a great place to visit, but the number of crystal shops outnumber the bars by like 6 to 1, which again, when you think of like a small rural town, you know, like that's a lot of crystal shops, you know,
that so is like, a lot of crystals.
So, and I was, I wasn't sure what to expect, but what turned out like pretty much everybody I talked to had some weird story. So the server in the hotel bar my first night there told me this kind of crazy story. And then the guy in the sporting goods store, he's like, well, I was up snowboarding on the mountain and I stopped and I looked up at the clouds and then 2 hours had passed by and I didn't know what. So what they will mostly tell you is that underneath Mount Shasta is the lost city of Telos, which is the last remnant of the continent of Lemuria. Which is this sort of fantastical, it's like Atlantis is in the Atlantic Ocean, Lemuria is in the Pacific Ocean.
And that's the divine, that's the female, correct?
Yeah, depending on who you talk to. So yeah, so like Lemurians get described sometimes as these kind of tall, advanced kind of, you know, sort of superhumans. And sometimes they get described in almost like Bigfoot fashion, like they're sort of hairy and kind of like, you know, kind of uncivilized and stuff like that. And some of them fly flying saucers and some of them are just normal looking people. So like this bartender told me the story about this. He was driving home one night and this hitchhiker picked up this guy who had around his neck a cage with a live raven around his neck. And he's like, well, where do you want to go? And the guy is like, can you take me up the side of the mountain? Like, you know, like 10 or 11 o'clock at night, he drives this random guy with a raven, like up into the wilderness, pitch black wilderness. He's like, you could stop here. And somewhere halfway upside the mountain, this guy just gets out and just walks into the darkness of the forest. And like the bartender's like, I don't know, was that a Lemurian? You know, so like everybody has these crazy stories there. And like,
oh, fun.
Yeah, it's a weird, fun, cool place. It was one of my
favorite. Did you experience anything, even the energy or anything from there?
I mean, it is definitely a beautiful, beautiful mountain. I mean, again, if you know it, it's like, you know, the High Cascades, they are all by themselves. You know, there's no like range or anything. It's just this lone mountain that just rises up out of nowhere. And it's really hard not to be moved by it. It's really hard to have that in your peripheral vision or like right. Just be up in the mountain there and not feel something. Now, was that the Lemurians or was that the beauty of nature? Like, I don't know, you know, like, but it's definitely a cool place. I definitely liked being there.